Hello there, world. I am Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Remember me? I lived in times of transitional peace through nonviolent means. However, it appears that the times that you're living in now have proven to be very different and more difficult times than when I was there with you. So I awaken to discover that some of you have slipped back and regressed into a dismal state that leaves me in a quandary of disbelief. When I left you, I left with the hopes that progress was inevitable and that the report that I would receive here would be one of encouragement, excitement, and immeasurably ecstasy. However, I'm reviewing the latest fashions, the latest trends, the ATVs, the e-blasts, and OMG Insider. And discovering that my dream is still not a reality. And may have even progressed into what looks like more like a nightmare than a reality. I'm just saying, America. So I'm choosing to reflect back upon the I Had a Dream speech that I wrote to you, which appears to keep a place in your programs that you have each January in my honor, and to convey to you what some of my concerns are. So let me first recap for your memory and point to some of the areas that I mentioned in my speech. I first spoke about the Emancipation Proclamation that was signed 50 years ago and what it was intended to do about the flames of withering injustice that was supposed to last for a lifetime for all of us, not just Negro slaves. But I'm awakened to find out that some of its momentous decree was never initiated, and some still swallow in injustices, and some still have a problem with it after all of these years. The doors of opportunity have been opened to all of God's children, as I mentioned, but the devastation appears gloomy because of what some have and have not done as they were given a door to walk through. And should I remind my people that in the process of gaining our rightful place, that we must not be guilty of wrongful deeds? I know that Rodney King was with you for a while and has left you now, but he was on to something when he pricked our conscience with that fateful saying and question that lived for a long time in us. Can we just all get along? It appears, though, that you've slipped into an insurmountable tumultuous coma that has left you without feelings of self-worth, which gives the appearance of the absence of caring for each other, which was always at the foundation of every triumph, every movement, every campaign, and just plain old human suffering. Desires to be happy by any means necessary, choosing not to drink from the cup of bitterness and hatred, but turning to self-mutilation with drugs, alcohol, gangs, and violence. I must question your motives, America. I've been awakened only to see that you now seek to be lavish with the theocracy of the rich and famous, for all by all. Should I take you back to that part of my speech where I encourage you to rise to the majestic heights of meeting physical force with soul force. Your heart must still guide your soul. And you must not give in to the pressure of the polls. So please do not excuse the behaviors of some of your brothers and sisters because of the weight of their books versus the weight of their crimes. Oh yes, I know that I've been gone from you for a long time now. But you must understand, America, that not only Negroes have voting rights, everybody can vote now. I also hear that our Hispanic, Asian, and third world country brothers and sisters have all made an expected arrival, and their visibility economically is formidable. In fact, I'm told that soon our Hispanic family status will no longer be in the minority status, but will matriculate into the majority. Therefore, take heed and beware in all areas. And oh, by the way, my fellow politicians, just a word to you as well. What you do privately yields public scrutiny now. Now you must understand that I'm speaking from an inward force that has guided my being from the point of my life to the point of my death. So my internal cues are still with me about you, America, and your being. Even though I've been awakened to the perils of your present state, I am still shaken by the news that infiltrates your homes daily. Have no end to the violence, injustices, demoralizing, bewilderment, trickery, scams, schemes, and divisiveness surrounding our once secured institutions of family, church, schools, and communities. America, what has happened to the fighters of the blood, sweat, and tears that dare not shake our beliefs, commitments, and vows that we not only thought about, but we lived out. Remember, I was once with you. I witnessed what we believed. Even when we were wrong with the sense that we agreed to disagree. I understand now that you do more violating each other than protecting each other. You do less talking and more acting out. Family has become separated instead of being united. I understand that there are more foster homes than parents at home. Had an opportunity to look at the latest hip-hop tracks. You now have DVD. YouTube. Where I am. And then I was torn by the fact